let's see children, how to remove the brackets. Now there are four different types of brackets, children, as you can see them over here. See, there are four different types of brackets, and the way we remove them is also in a sequence or in an order. That means there's a perfect order in which you are going to remove the bracket. Now this bracket is known as, children, the small brackets or the parentheses. This one is a middle brackets or the curly brackets. The third one are the big brackets or the square brackets. And then there is a line bracket, children. It is just a line that is shown. So that is known as the vinculum. Okay, so there is an order in which we remove. The first thing we remove over here, children, will be a vinculum, that is the line bracket, just a bar. Then you remove the small brackets. Then comes the middle bracket, and then last comes the square bracket. So in this way, children, we remove the brackets which are given in an algebraic expression. So let's see how to do the exercise. That is the exercise B, which will contain these brackets, and then it will also have the operations such as the plus or the minus and all those things. So let's get started with the exercise. So we begin with question number one, children, that is evaluate. Evaluate means to get to the final answer. Now see, the question is 23 minus 15, outside the bracket it is plus 4. So the first thing is, children, we need to solve the bracket. This is no sign, means it's a plus sign. So plus minus is minus. Subtract 15 from 23, that is 8. You can open the bracket then, and with that, plus 4 means 8 plus 4, 12. So that is how you get to the first one. Then let's see the second one. The second one is, children, 5x outside the bracket, then plus 3x plus 7x inside the bracket. Now inside the bracket, because both of them are the like terms means they have the same variable. You can add them up together or subtract, whatever the signs are. So 3x plus 7x will make it how much, children? 10x plus 5x outside the bracket. So 10 plus 5 will make it 15x. The third subpart is, children, 6m is outside the bracket, then a minus sign, and then inside the bracket 4m minus m. Now first we'll solve the bracket. No sign means it's a plus. Plus minus is minus. So from 4m you will subtract 1m. Now no number written over here, children, it means it's 1. So 4 minus 1 will give you 3m. Now just outside, this is a plus 3m, children, because we put the sign of the bigger value. But just outside the bracket, whenever there is a minus sign, it changes the sign inside because it is being multiplied. So it changes the sign inside. Plus into minus is minus. So 6m minus 3m, a plus 3m now becomes a minus 3m. Now plus minus is again minus, so 3m. Then I have taken the fourth one. 3y plus 8y minus 5y outside the bracket. Now again, solve the bracket first. 8 plus 3, 11y minus 5y. So from 11 you subtract the 5y, you get the answer as 6y. Now one thing more, children, if a minus sign is given outside the bracket after the bracket, right, over here also we had a minus sign but it was before the bracket, so it changed the sign. But if a minus sign is given outside the bracket but it is after the bracket, then it will not affect the sign inside, then the sign will remain the same. So this is a very important point, you should remember this point. Now there are a few more questions of question number one that I have not done, that you can do it yourself. Coming to question number two, children, simplify. It also means that you have to evaluate to the final answer. Doing the second one, 10m plus outside the bracket, then 4n minus 3n, then bracket is closed, minus 5n. Now again, we'll start with solving the bracket. 10m plus, now this is a plus sign, this is a minus sign. You subtract, you get 1n with the positive sign. So we don't write the positive sign. Minus 5n. Now once the purpose of the bracket is done, we are going to open the bracket. So 10m plus 1m minus 5n. Now n and n are the like terms, children. You can subtract or add whatever the signs say. So plus minus is minus. So we have subtracted 4n and the sign of the bigger value. So minus 4n. So 10m minus 4n becomes the answer. The third subpart, children, 15b minus 6b inside the bracket, minus again another bracket also, 8b plus 4b. Now, because both are the small brackets children, we can start solving both the brackets in the same steps. So let's solve. This is a plus and minus, so minus, that is 9b, this minus sign, and then this is also plus and plus is addition, so this 12b. Now, because the brackets have been solved, we are going to remove the brackets in the next step. 9b minus 12b. Plus minus is minus, so you are going to subtract at the sign of the bigger value, so minus 3b. Next one is, see, we have a lot of minus signs. So how are we going to do it? Let's start. First, the bracket solving, children. Minus minus means we are going to add, but the sign will come of the bigger value. So minus minus is minus only, but add the value, so 8 plus 4 is 12a. Okay, now just outside the bracket, I told you if it is a minus sign, children, it changes the sign inside. Why? Because minus into minus is plus, so a minus 12a will now become a plus 12a. Okay, coming to the 8 subpart, children, 3x plus, then a bracket is there, minus, again a bracket is there. Because both of them are the same kind of bracket, so we will solve them together. 3x plus, now this is a plus and a minus means minus, so 3x with a sign of the bigger value, that's a plus. Minus, now over here 7x and minus x will minus sign of the bigger value, so 6x. Now in the next step, we are going to open the brackets. 3x plus 3x, because it's a plus sign, so the sign remains the same. This minus will make this plus 6x as minus 6x, and now we have the numbers. So this is a plus 6x and this is a minus 6x. Plus minus is minus, so 0 is our answer. The 10th subpart, children, 6a squared plus, then the brackets are given. How are we going to do it? Now inside the bracket, if it is a like term, children, you can solve them, but if it is an unlike term, we cannot solve them. So 6a squared plus, this is a plus 2a and a minus 2a, so plus minus is minus, 1a squared, or I can also write only a squared. 1 I have written so that you get clear, right? Nothing written over here, it means it's a 1, right? Minus, now these are unlike terms, children, you can't solve them. So we have kept them like that only. Now in the next step, I'm going to remove the brackets, that is, I'm going to open up my brackets. 6a squared plus 1a squared. Minus will change the signs inside, so minus a square and the minus b square will now be written as plus b square. Now we are going to bring the like terms together we have already arranged, so we can solve them. This is a, see over here, no sign means plus, so 6 plus 1, 7 a square minus a square plus b square. Now again, these are like terms, children, because the variable part is same. So you can solve them. Plus minus is minus, so 6a square plus b square. The 14th subpart, children, 25y minus, then there is a long bracket. Okay, so what are we going to do? We are going to open up the bracket. We can open up the bracket, but because it has certain like terms inside, so we can rearrange and bring the like terms together. So in the next step, I'm going to bring the like terms together. So 5x plus 6x minus 10y minus 3y. Now because it is like term, it can be solved also, children. So plus plus is plus, add them, 11x, and minus minus is also addition, sign of the bigger value. So 10 plus 3 is 13y minus sign. Now these are, children, unlike terms. You can't solve them. So we move on to the next step and we open up the bracket. Just outside the bracket, there's a minus sign. So what will happen? It will change the signs inside. So 25y plus 11x will now be written as minus 11x, and minus 13y will now be written as plus 13y. Now after this, we can bring the like terms together. So 25y plus 13y can be written near to it, and minus 11x. Now you can solve these. This is addition. So 38y minus 11x. So that becomes your answer. Taken the 16th one, children, because it has this vinculum is also there, the bar bracket. A minus, then the question is written. Now remember, children, this bar bracket is just above 4a plus 3a. This minus sign is outside the bracket. See, this bar is not put above minus, so that means this minus is outside the bracket. Okay, so first we are going to only solve 4a plus 3a. A minus 2a, this minus sign, children, and plus plus is plus, so 7a. Now just outside the bracket there was a minus sign, so my plus 7a will now be written as minus 7a. Now this is a plus sign, this is a minus sign, so further we can solve them, subtract them, and the sign of the bigger value is minus. Outside this bracket, children, again a minus sign means minus will change the sign. Why? Because minus into minus is plus. So a plus 5a. Now both are like terms, add them, so the final answer is a plus 6. Coming to the 16th subpart, children, 5x square minus, then inside the bracket we have certain terms. How are we going to solve it? Now once we see the terms inside the bracket, children, they are all unlike terms because the variable part is different for them, right? So what are we going to do? We can't solve the bracket, so we just simply open the bracket. Why? Because nothing can be solved. And when you open the bracket, you see just outside the bracket there is a minus sign. So what will this minus sign do, children? It will change all the signs of the terms that are there inside. Now this is a repeated step, children, by mistake. Now move to the next step. Now once the sign will change the sign, the plus 3x will be written as minus 3x. Minus x square will be a plus x square, and a plus 4 will be a minus 4. Now rearrange and bring the like terms together. So 5x square plus x square minus 3x and minus 4. Now these two, because they are the like terms, they can be added up together. A plus and a plus is added up together. 6x square minus 3x and minus 4. So this becomes the answer. Now moving to the next question, children, question number 3, which is again simplify. Now simplify means the same thing, children, you have to get to the final answer. So let's see. Now this one I have taken the first one because this was a long question and many of you will get scared seeing to the long question. So I'm going to explain you this one, children. It is very easy. Let's see how to go about it. Now just outside the brackets, children, we will be very careful about the signs that are there inside. First, we will check the terms inside the bracket if they can be solved. But because in all the three brackets we have unlike terms, we have to open the bracket. Just outside the bracket, a minus sign. So a plus y will be written as minus y, and a minus z will become a plus z. Then this plus x. Again, a plus sign outside the bracket. No signs will change, but it will open up the bracket. So a plus y and a minus z. This plus y. And again a minus sign outside the bracket will change the signs inside. So this will be written as plus z will be now a minus z, and a minus x will be written as a plus x. Next step, children, rearrange the like terms together. I have brought all the like terms together. You can also put them inside a bracket for your convenience if you want. So all the x's, y and the z's have come together. Now according to the signs you have to do. Now a plus sign with all the three, so 3x, and this is a plus y and a minus y, children. I can cancel these terms here only, so a plus y only. Again a plus z and a minus z can be cancelled, so a minus z. So this becomes your answer. The second subpart, children, again you can see there are three different kind of brackets that have been used over here. So let's see how to begin. We'll start with the first one, that are the small brackets. So x, and when you solve one bracket, children, don't change any of the terms. You have to copy down the terms as they are written. So I have copied down everything, and this minus sign over here will change the signs inside. So plus y is minus y, and a plus x is a minus x. Now inside this curly bracket, once we have opened the bracket, we have the next bracket, that is the curly bracket. And inside the curly bracket, children, this is a plus x and this is a minus x. So both of them can be cancelled here only. So we are left with minus y. Just outside the bracket, there is a plus sign. So the sign inside will not change. So y and this minus y. Curly bracket has opened. Now this is a plus y and a minus y. Again, they can be cancelled over here only. So that means there is nothing inside the bracket. So we are left with the answer as x. The next one, 2 and then in a bracket minus 5 and then a bracket. Now inside a bracket, unlike terms, you can't do anything. Now between the bracket and the number, children, there is no sign. That means it's a multiplication. So multiply this number with both the terms that are there inside the bracket. 3 2s are 6a, plus minus is minus, 2 into 1 is 2 1s are 2b. Now with minus 5, you have to multiply the terms inside. So minus into plus is minus. 5 into 1 is 5a. Okay. Then minus into minus is plus. 5 threes are 15b. Now after this step, you can rearrange the like terms together and do whatever the question says. So plus minus is minus, so a. And again plus minus is minus, sign of the bigger value, so plus 13b. I've taken the sixth subpart, children, because it has all the four different kind of brackets. We begin with the first one, that's the bar. Now the bar is put above b minus c. And inside this bar, these are unlike terms, so you can't solve them. Just outside the bar bracket, there's a minus sign, so it will change the signs inside. So you will write a minus b plus c. This minus c will change into plus c. Now again in this bracket, children, all three are unlike terms, you can't do anything. Just outside the bracket, there's a minus sign, so the signs of all these terms will change. Plus a is minus a, a plus b, and a minus c. So this is the curly bracket. Now just outside the curly bracket, again a minus sign, that means once again all the signs are going to change now and the curly bracket will be removed. So minus a is now plus a, minus b, and a plus c. Again all our three are unlike. Just outside the square bracket, there's a minus sign again, all the signs will change again. So a minus a, a plus b, and a minus c. Now this plus a and minus a can be cancelled over here together, so we have the answer left as b minus c. Now this was a good question, children, you should practice doing it and try to solve only one in one step. Only one bracket should be removed. Don't try to add up and do everything in one go. Next I'm going to teach you the seventh one, children, again because it has three brackets over here. So let's see, in the first step we are going to focus over here at this bracket. Unlike terms, and just outside the bracket are 2, so with 2 you are going to multiply. Okay, so rest I have copied down the same thing till here. Plus and plus, plus into plus is plus. 2 into 10 is 20y. Plus into minus is minus. 2 into x is 2x. Coming to the next step now, children, the bracket is removed. We come to the curly bracket. Similar terms or the like terms can be added up together. So 20y and 6y will give me 26y minus 2x. I'm only solving one thing in one step. Next step, children. Now nothing more can be solved, so we have to remove this bracket. Just outside the curly bracket, there's a minus sign, so it will change the signs inside. In the next step, 5y plus 26 becomes minus 26, and a minus 2x becomes a plus 2x. Again, like terms are here. We have to subtract this time, sign of the bigger value, minus 21y plus 2x. Nothing more can be solved. We move on to the next step. Outside a bracket, again a minus sign. It will change the signs inside. So it is a plus 21y minus 2x. This and this, x and x can still be worked out together. So 3x minus 2x is x plus 21y. This is the last subpart that I have done for this exercise, children. That is, I have copied down the question. This is a bar. Just outside a bar, there is a minus sign. So you will have to change the signs inside, children. A plus a will become a minus a, and a minus 2 will now become a plus 2. Now what can be done over here? This a plus a and minus a can be cancelled. So we are left with 2 only. This 2 will be multiplied with a outside because there is no sign between a and the bracket. Right? That is what I have written over here. Now you multiply, minus into plus is minus 2a. A square minus 2a, children, nothing can be solved. Just outside the bracket there is 5. No sign means it's a multiplication. Multiply 5 with both the terms here. 5 into a square is 5a square. Plus into minus is minus. 5 2s are 10a. This becomes the answer. And so with this we come to an end of this long exercise. I hope, children, after seeing the entire video and after listening to me very carefully, you have understood each and everything that I have tried to explain you. Now, if you have really understood the lesson well, don't forget to please subscribe, like, and do share my videos with many of your friends so that they also are being helped by me, that is Mrs. D. Nandan. So, thank you and have a wonderful day ahead. Bye-bye.